Yo, salute to Bad Baby. Bad Baby infamously made $50 million last year. Money getter. She made $50 million off OnlyFans. I think she just gave up on music. She bought like a crazy house like in Florida. Like it was $7 million. I thought she was dating, I remember the nigga named Young Bands. Wasn't Young Bands dating her? Young Bands, Bad Baby, right? Yeah, she was dating Young Bands. At least when she was 17 and he was 20. Yeah, but I think they were dating for a while. And obviously she became overage at that point and whatever. I think he was 21, she was 18. Anyway, here's the point. Young Bands ain't got a motherfucking thing going on in music. Nigga, if I'm him, nigga, I turn to Safari. Nigga, Bad Baby's getting the bag, bro. Like, I don't know if they're still together, but Young Bands better stay with her. That's a fact. She's getting the bag. Anyway, she kind of debuted a new look, and a lot of people are commenting on it because she looks biracial. This might be a filter, but I'm going to be honest with you. I think what's happening nowadays is so ironic because, you know, it's so interesting, actually. I go to Miami a lot. And when I go to Miami a lot, all these women are getting under the knife and they're getting surgery, especially women that aren't of color. If you're white, if you're Hispanic, if you're whatever else, except black, these women all want to look like Kylie Jenner. And when they want to look like Kylie Jenner, they all want to have like this kind of tint to their skin. They don't want to be as pale as they really are. They want to have these over accentuated lips. Oftentimes it looks like duck or fish lips. I hate it, especially with a bunch of women. But like white women, they don't like the white lips no more. And then also they all rock the same lace front. You know what I mean? Like there was a time in the past, not that I agree with it, a lot of black women used to be like, they used to call white people or Hispanic people hair good hair and almost down on the Afro Negro hair. But even white people wear weave. Like white people be rocking the lace fronts and all that because it's just the look. They're all mirroring what the Kardashians has set in place as what's popping. So even if they have the hair texture that supposedly is preferred, they all put on a lace front. They're all super gluing some shit to their fucking forehead. They're all like doing the fucking bubble lip shit, which looks like they just fucking like just suction cup their lips. And they all want to have like this particular tint to their skin to look like they're exotic, right? I think, you know, if you remember how Kylie looked when she was younger, bro, she's a white girl. She's this young white girl. That's what was happening. Then she just all of a sudden changed into like some exotic looking, socially ambiguous, yo, could be from the Caribbean, but also like, it's weird. And I see Bad Baby debut this look and I'm like, maybe it's a filter. I go to the next picture and I'm like, this ain't no filter. This is a fucking tan. Like this is some other shit. Actually, this don't even look like Bad Baby. I ain't gonna lie to you. But it's kind of crazy how, you know, when people talk about, you know, that European look and like how, you know, they always got at magazine covers and talk about how it affects like young girls coming up. And I've always like, you know, even when I'm with like, you know, women who are, you know, they could be just fully black or women who maybe they have just, I've always told a girl, I'd rather you have a little afro rather than you go get some lace. I don't like weave and I don't like wigs. I don't like neither of them. For women who I want to take serious, if I'm just piping the shit out of you, you can have whatever fucking contraption you want to have on your head. But if I'm about to take you serious, I don't want you to be sleeping in a bunch of bullshit and then like you got to like go through a 3-hour process to make yourself up into some bullshit. Like, you're impressing more people outside than me. If I want to be attracted to you when I wake up, not be attracted to you when we're going out for other people. It's a waste of time. However, a lot of women kind of do this shit. And I look at somebody like Bad Baby and I'm like, you got all the money. Like, I'm wondering why the fuck she would even be doing any of this shit. And I'm not trying to intimate that maybe she has some type of just insecurity about herself, but like this look don't make sense to me. It really just don't make sense to me. It's like white people don't want to be white people. Black people definitely don't want to be black people, right? And Hispanics want to either be white or extra black. It's crazy. It's like we live in a time where everybody wants to be someone else and no one's actually happy with themselves. You can't even find a woman these days who at the heart of themselves say they wouldn't get surgery. The most they'll say, like the thing you got to be accepted, they'll be like, oh, I wouldn't get surgery now, but if I ever get a kid, I'm getting my ass done. But most of them are going to be like, well, my titties are a little small. I would definitely just get some titties. Or they'd be like, I'm good, but yeah, I could do with a BBL. I feel these days we live in a time where people just don't like themselves. Somebody said this is mental illness. I don't know if it's mental illness or is just societal pressures. Like we live in a society where there's so much pressures to be perfect. And nobody will ever be perfect. And even the people that are perfect, or you would say are the closest to perfection naturally, you, in whatever perfection mold that you have in your mind, they yearn to be other things. There's always going to be something. Like, I was looking at this one chick I know. She's from, like, Florida. A lot of dudes like her. She's cool. She's cute. But it's the teeth. For her, it's the teeth. And then once the teeth is done, now she's going back to the body. Because now everybody wants to be like this perfect fucking image. And, you know, it's kind of sad because, you know, I see women more affected by it because a lot of women, they feel their value lies in their beauty. And a lot of women also chase that idea of trying to maintain their beauty for a long enough time. But it's kind of sad a little bit, you know? Somebody said chickless teeth. Yeah, I always hate that when I see it. But yeah, I look at this. This don't even, I kid you not, if I didn't see this posted on Bad Baby's page, I would never know it's her. I would never know this is Bad Baby at all. And by the way, I'm not saying she doesn't look bad here. She doesn't look bad. I'm just saying, like, damn, it looked like she's, and again, I'm making assumptions here. Maybe she just wanted to try something new, but damn. Just knowing if you know a little bit about her and how everything is, and clearly, and this is where I think OnlyFans also comes into detriment for a lot of young girls. When you have people judging your value based on how you look physically, right? You see, everybody loves talking about they got mad bands from OnlyFans, and she's made the most, $50 million in a year. But when you have women who judge their value on how people perceive them physically, not on how smart they are, not on how they are as a person, how nice they are, it's only about a physical look, it becomes almost like seeking something that could, it's trying to fill a cup that could never be filled. And we got to think about that when we think about, like, you know, the effects of like an OnlyFans. Because a lot of people look at OnlyFans like there is no effect. You know, obviously there's going to be effect when you have kids and maybe they see it. But like, what's the effect on people's judging you just on your looks and you realizing your earned income is solely based up on what these dudes desire you to look like, and now you're trying to change it. Like, a lot of people say, even with Michael Jackson, like, he was changing his body to try to appease, you know, an audience and trying to do certain things, and he ended up developing more problems by doing that. Who knows? There's another picture. Yeah, I kid you not. I would never know this is Bad Baby. I kid you not. I would never know. I see somebody in the comment section says that she wants to be black so bad. I don't think this is a black thing. By the way, I think this mad, like, I know obviously, like, being black is beautiful and it's wonderful. And I know, like, you know, I'm very proud to be black. But here's the thing. The new standard everybody's chasing is not to be black. It's to be the socially ambiguous, mixed, like, in this range of long hair, nice tinted skin, great lip. Like, it's this mix of everything that kind of almost don't exist, right? It's kind of like that exotic type. It's not like these chicks ain't trying to be black, bro. Like, you know what I mean? Unless you think having a, that's what, when people say trying to be black, they think having an ass is black. No. These days, there was a time that white chicks didn't have ass. Everybody is just like a pre-requirement. Everybody got a little bit of ass or some shit like that. Whether you got like some, like a little bump or somebody got a little skinny BBL or somebody just got some over the top shit. But these women these days, I think they're all chasing, it's not to be black, it's chasing maybe some black features like the lips. The lips are obviously what you could say is very natural to black people in terms of features, but I don't think these chicks are trying to be black. I think these chicks are trying to fit a mold that somebody like a Kim K or a Kylie has set for them. You get what I mean? Yeah, no, the lips is definitely a black feature, but like these chicks, play this. If they're trying to be black, they won't go darker than this. Like, they're not trying to do no basically blackface shit. Like, they all want to be light enough that they could look Spanish. Like, let's keep it real. There ain't nobody be like, yo, I want to look hella dark. Nobody's on that. Somebody says the best features from each race. And that's subjective, but I get what you mean, and I think that that might be true, right? So if they'd be like, oh, well, Hispanic women have this, they try to get that. Oh, black women have really nice lips, they try to get the lips. Oh, so-and-so have certain facial structure, cheekbones, they want to get that. Yeah, I agree with that. Somebody said she looked Israeli. Somebody said they chase perfection, which is not black or white. Yes, I agree. Perfection, what they're calling perfection. You know what the craziest thing is? And that's why I've said, like, I've never been attracted to people that are, like, plasticky. Like, I always just think perfection is in imperfection. You know what I mean? Like, any woman I've ever been with, I've tried to, like uplift, or I think I have, try to uplift what they might see as their insecurities. But let me tell you this. Women like to be like, oh, no, the only reason I got my ass done is because you niggas like bitches with fat ass. Stop it. Niggas was down to pipe you out before you had the ass, the surgery. You know how many chicks who like I was trying to fly out back in the day and they'd be like, yo, I can't come after this day because I'm about to get the surgery and then I got to take this time for recovery. And I'm like, shorty, I'm cool with smashing you with the quote unquote flat ass you got. These chicks ain't doing it for niggas, man. They doing it for some other, it's some self-esteem fucked up shit going on in their mind. Like, they like to blame it on dudes. Well, you it's like when women tell you, well, so what if I do some hoe shit now? You niggas like hoes. You're not being a hoe because we like hoe. You're a fucking hoe. That's what, yo, you ever hear this shit when women try to blame it on us? Well, you niggas only, bruh, stop it. Niggas is down to pipe you out before you got surgery. Ain't no nigga be like, oh, nah, she ain't got a BBL. Nah, we good. Nah, we straight. No, niggas down to slang cargo. These chick is fucked up in their own mind. And they just blame it on niggas. Oh, I'm only getting my body done because, yo, I'm telling you, a chick did some hoe shit and she looked at me and be like, but you like hoes. I'm like, no, I don't. Like, I like piping hoes. But, like, I'm looking for a chick that I can hang around with. That's not going to be a hoe. You wanted to be a hoe. Like, you picked your choice. Don't try to blame it on the guy. You know what I mean? Somebody said 21 Savage tweet. All right, we're done with Bad Baby. Bad Baby, I'm glad she's doing well, though. I'm glad she's doing well.